Have you ever needed to integrate real-time weather data for a location or locations into your control system? Maybe you'd like to tune your environmental controls to be more efficient by taking into account the outside weather conditions. Or maybe adverse weather conditions are detrimental to your operations and you'd like to be able to control whether you're running or not automatically based on the current weather conditions. With the JSON OPC server, it's easy to gain access to accurate real-time weather data via OPC or Wunderware SuiteLink interfaces from your control system. In this video, I'll be covering how to use a comprehensive weather API that we typically use for these purposes called Open Weather Map, which provides access to current weather or several different types of forecasts for pretty much anywhere in the world. Here we have the Open Weather Map website. There's a couple of different ways that we can access weather data. By city ID, as you can see here, there are some sample files available to determine what your city ID is. These are compressed files, so you just download the file that you're interested in, and once that's extracted, you can view that, and you can view those in any text editor. So if I go down here, I have open Notepad++, which I find has excellent search capabilities, and I find Charlotte in my city list with a city ID of 446-0243, and that's what I would use in my URL in order to access the current weather for Charlotte, North Carolina. So now that I know the city ID, I'll just show you the example of what the URL would look like. The URL for the Charlotte city code, you'll see here, there's weather ?ID, and that's equal to my 446-0243. And that's the URL I would use in my JSON OPC server to access the current weather. In addition to that, I have to specify a unique app ID, and I gain that app ID when I sign up for a free login on openweathermap.com. So back on the website, as you see here, you just go to the top, and there's a sign-up option. So you click there to sign up for a free account, and then you'll get your own unique app ID, which you have to use in those URLs in order to access the API. Now, in addition to that, I can access weather, current weather by geographic coordinates, so latitude or longitude. And if I look back in that file, you'll see that I can find the longitude and latitude for each city that's listed in there as well. By zip code, so basically here's the example format. You do the zip code and country code separated by a comma. And if I wanted to do by zip code for Software Toolbox's office, that's a zip code of 28105, US. If I wanted to use that format. Now, aside from that, you can call on current weather data from several cities. So, for instance, by city ID, I can specify multiple city IDs separated by commas in that URL and get the data from multiple cities that way. If I need to display multiple cities. Now, in addition to current weather, you'll see there's all sorts of different options for forecast data and historical data that you can access the formats to use those in the JSON OPC server as well, if you need that data. Now, aside from the different formats, the website also provides detailed information about what fields are returned in the JSON responses. So you'll see here's a parameter list of all the different information that you're going to get returned when you specify a URL. For instance, you'll see the item ID for the main temperature parameter is main.temp, and the default units are in degrees Kelvin. You can specify metric for Celsius or imperial for Fahrenheit to get all of your temperatures and other variables in those varying different units of measure. So for the purposes of this demo, I'm going to be using imperial units so that I can get my temperatures in Fahrenheit, wind speeds and miles per hour, things of that nature. You simply add the ampersand units dash and then imperial or metric to make that change in your URL so that you get that. Now, once you've determined the format of the URL that you need, it's easy to configure the JSON OPC server to expose the weather data. 1st, we just need to launch our system management console, either from Start Programs, Connect Software. You can launch this from the Start menu group for Wonderware. I just had a shortcut here. Once I'm in the SMC, I'm just going to go into the hierarchy and expand DA Server Manager, default group, and we have a local host node. If I expand that, I'm interested in connectsoft.dascxsjson.1. If I go to the configuration, add a port object, the port object, that's where there are any temporary or purchase licenses are going to be imported, as you can see here. Now, for trial purposes, if you download the trial version, you just leave this section as is to get the standard 2-hour trial mode, which gives you unlimited connections. So once I have that configured, I'm going to right-click and add a JSON service object. This is where the bulk of the configuration takes place. As you can see, there isn't a lot to configure. The JSON service URL is the URL we determined earlier from the API that we want to access. So you can simply enter that or copy and paste it. I'm going to go back into that Notepad document. I'm just going to copy my Charlotte City code so that I can get the weather at the Software Toolbox offices. I'm going to copy that, and I'm going to go back to my SMC and paste that right into the URL field. The JSON server also supports optional user authentication for JSON services that require that. So I can enter a username or a password if my server is going to require that in order to access the data. Now, the Open Weather Map API doesn't require user authentication, so I'm just going to leave those fields blank. Now, for an OPC connection, that's pretty much it for the configuration settings. You'll see here OPC online namespace is enabled by default. That allows OPC DA clients to browse the JSON service namespace and see all of those different parameters or variables that are available automatically. Now, if you're using a SweetLink or a DDE connection, you could disable that. For SweetLink or DDE, I need to add a device group, which is going to correspond to my topic when I configure an access name. So I'm just going to add a topic called Charlotte Weather, and I'm going to keep the update interval at the default, which is 1,000 milliseconds. And that's going to be my topic later when I go into InTouch that I'm going to use when I configure my access name. For device items, you can add up to 1,000 different named aliases for actual item references. So for instance, I'm going to add an alias called Charlotte Temp, and my item reference is going to be that main.temp syntax that we saw on the Open Weather Map reference information on the website. So main.temp, and you'll see, I'm just going to bring that back up and show you where I found that. You see main.temp there. That's the item syntax for accessing that from the JSON query. So now I've now added an alias that can be used as the item name over in InTouch or browsed from any OPC client, which you'll see. Save those changes, and that's pretty much it. The last step is just to activate the server. So right-click, activate server. And you'll see the server runtime is now active and can be accessed by a client application. So just for demonstration purposes, I'm going to set up a quick and simple OPC connection using my OPC DA client. So I'm going to open the OPC Quick client. First, I have to add a connection. I'm going to browse a list of available servers. I need connectsoft.dascxsjson.1 as my OPC prog ID. Add an OPC group to that. I'll keep the defaults. Add item or items to that. So once I'm adding items, I can expand my browse space, and under the service object, here's a list of all those available parameters that we saw names for on the website. You'll see I also have Charlotte Temp, which is my alias. So if I browse down, I'm just going to add a few of the variables. I'm going to select the current temperature, which we're definitely interested in. So main.temp. I'd also like to add my humidity. So let's find that in the list. There's main.humidity. So I'm just going to add that one as well. And then one last one. I'll add my wind speed, which is wind.speed. And then just for display purposes, I'd like to add the name of my location. So if I browse down and select name, I'll click OK to that. And you'll see there I have my values populated, temperature in degrees Fahrenheit. I've got my percent humidity and my wind speed in miles per hour. So all imperial units, and then the name of my location, which is Charlotte. And we could display all sorts of the other properties that you saw were browsable and available: atmospheric pressure, location coordinates, names, cloud cover, etc. If I go back into the browse, you'll see there's that Charlotte Temp, which is my alias. If I add that one, and since I added it after the fact, I'd have to wait on the next query. So I'm just going to go ahead and do a quick manual poll to get that value updated, and you'll see that matches right up with my actual variable name of main.temp. So Charlotte Temp, I can use that in my InTouch app. So I'm just going to go ahead and quickly bring up a sample InTouch app that I already have configured with a window, labeling, and a value display. I'm going to set this value up displayed as being an analog expression. I'm going to use my Charlotte Temp alias as the tag name. Define that as a real, since it is a temperature. Set that to a type of IO real. And I need to assign an access name, so I'm going to add a new access name. I'm going to call that JSON. Since this is a local connection, I'll leave my node name blank. My application name is going to be, to correspond to the JSON server, is going to be DAS CXS JSON. And then for my topic name, that's going to match that item group that I added over in the server. So I'm going to define that as Charlotte Weather. And we're making a sweet link connection, so we're going to leave that protocol. And for the item name, since I used my item name from the server, I'm just going to check the use tag name as item name. And I'm going to save these settings off and apply everything. And now, if I just go to my InTouch runtime, okay, that's going to come up, and you'll see that I'm receiving the current temperature in Charlotte in degrees Fahrenheit, right, my InTouch application. And you'll see that matches up with what my OPC DA test client has as well. And with that, I mean, it's just that easy to integrate weather data from virtually any location right into your control system using the JSON OPC server.